Ladies and gentlemen, I'm aware that New South Wales Police Force are in receipt of at least two pieces of social media footage depicting incidents arising from last weekend's gay and lesbian Mardi Gras.
Hey,
both of those pieces of footage have given rise to the initiation by New South Wales Police Force of our complaints management process. We have, as a consequence, this morning initiated two internal investigations to inquire into the full circumstances of both those incidents. One at 10 p.m. on Saturday evening, last Saturday evening, on Oxford Street near the corner of Riley Street. The second occurring around 11:30 p.m. on Oxford Street near the corner of Crown Street.
But as Mr. Murdoch pointed out, we have the ability to instigate the complaint ourselves, which we've done immediately upon becoming aware of the footage. And I think that does show that we are serious about the actual investigation, but also serious about the relationships that we have and acknowledge the importance of those relationships.
In the video that's on YouTube, an officer is heard repeatedly asking the person filming to stop filming. Is that part of police training, to stop people using their iPhones or cameras to film police in action? To stop?
I know it's not against
filming,
law.
Mate.
It's not against law.
Good.
It's not against filming.
Well, I don't have to.
Good.
Absolutely not. In fact, it's contrary to our media policy. Again, I would suggest that unfortunately shows a degree of naivety of the police involved who made those comments. We understand and accept, and in fact support the right of the community to film anyone in a public space. We do it ourselves as part of our operational duty. So no, that is not something they were told. In fact, quite the contrary. Our police, again, need to be mature enough to know that everyone on the street basically has a mobile phone with camera facility and they are going to be filmed and recorded.
Will you see?
Before Mardi Gras on Saturday night, the officers who were working were given a very good briefing about Mardi Gras itself, obviously, about the history of Mardi Gras and also about some of the issues or concerns of the community. But then more broadly, we do a lot of education across New South Wales Police about what we're trying to do to build our relationships with the GLBTI communities and about understanding the concerns and issues the GLBTI community has with police and trying to break down those barriers and build those bridges so that there is more confidence.
Last Saturday night we saw 10,000 participants, a crowd around 300,000, 110 floats, and one of the floats was a New South Wales Police Force float. We had a large number of police marching in the parade and the organisers of the event actively seek out our participation. Our relationship has never been better, so it was a great night for everyone, with the exception of these two incidents we know.